So, I got this clock right here. I'm gonna show you this. I finally plugged it back in. And it works. This is a GE clock radio cassette player, which the cassette player on this one does not work. Or like spats or VHS lights. This one's cassette does not work. It's broken for some reason. Now I can get the, it needs this noise. It also needs this weird, awkward noise right here. Fuzzy sound. Sucky noise. So, I can think the cassette player's probably shot, and I broke the door. It completely did this one, and then it did it with no sound. It did it, and the sound completely went away on the cassette player, so. But when I had a cassette, one of the cassette adapters in it, the sound completely went away. After that, it was playing fine. We can still hear a little static and turn it down. But it's a little staticky. I think it just needs to flip the capacitors or something in it. Or shot. It really works. But if you can hear it, there's a little bit static there. I guess I hear a radio a little bit. I'm trying to turn it all the way. I've been listening to it. This is the classic rock. You got a bass on it, say. This is why I like the old clock. I guess they actually last longer. This one's probably quite daycare. This one had to be made around, I'm guessing around 91, because according to state code, six, and there's 91 and 5. So this is it for, I guess, this is for the month. This means it's made in May 6, 1991. I mean, it's probably one of the last ones they made. This came from a department store that went out of business in 95. Because I had an original box of this, but the box got destroyed. I guess the original owner threw it back in its box when the, because these buttons right here, the W1MS4 does not function anymore. When the controller did work, I could not get the rewind or password. So whatever, I could not get that to work. So I was thinking just, take this thing apart and find a spare one that has a working cassette player and replace the cassette player itself. This player's got a whole bunch of serviceable parts. The clock is right, because if I would show you right now my thing, but the air clock in here is right. I'm OCD about all clocks being wrong and fast. I like these clocks to be right. I got a clock right there, it's right. We got the kitchen, the doors in the kitchen are right, and I can tell you, if you look at the computer, that's right, it's 5 o'clock. 5 in the afternoon. Here it says 5 p.m. Your computer's logged in. But yeah, every clock in here is always. Oh, you can't see the mic, but the sun's just shining on that one. But yeah, the clock in here is always right. You may like this clock. I like this display, because right in my aunt's old Sears one, it had this kind of display on it. I think that one had a bigger one. But it had this kind of fluorescent display like that, and it was a Sears X, IXL, or something like that. Solid state. Yeah, and it's got dual alarms. My aunt's, that's weird, because my aunt's had a dual alarm thing to it, too. So, that clock I don't have anymore. I snatched it when it was all broken. It was messing up. See, alarm one, alarm two. So, it's got his and her alarm. Fast forward. So, I like this one, because you can actually set, because usually you can't slow down on the forward. This way you can slow down forward. It's got two slow words. It's got two options for both fast, up, down, back and forth, fast, for the quarterback, for the four reverse, kind of set the, for slow and fast option. Because I like the slow option too. Like the fast option didn't hit, but I'm going to slow down, like slow down. And it's a time set button right here, which I set the time already. The alarm does work. I might set the alarm and see if it goes off. See how it works. Just put the set mode, put alarm on. I get the PM. Back. Three and four buzzer. It's got 10 seconds left, so here we go. 10, 9, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. It should go off. Come on. Yeah, it works. And the radio part does work too. Boy, it works. The radio alarm works too. I actually got the radio go off. Dozen times. And I believe you could also hit play. I think they should have did that when you hit play. And it would go on standby mode. I mean, I don't like the option where they get turned. You can both when radio both on or off, hit plays, cassette plays. I don't have the option where it would play the cassettes, like the Sony. YouTube Mobile 3 actually had the one of my uncle used to have the cassette player one. I like that one too. Wish I could find it, but I find it eBay once in a while. And sometimes I did find the one my aunt used to have, the clocker she used to have, but it's hard to find that one, too, because the cassette players go out. So my aunt's was, hers was a stereo sound. Hers had built-in stereo sound. You sleep, the brightness control, which is just bright and then dimmed. There's still two options. Sleep, radio on, radio off. This is one of the best radios I ever heard. This is like a really good radio. 9-volt battery compartment. It's still there, still intact. I might just cut it off and but I won't leave everything original. But it does look like it's got some wear and tear here. And it looks like this thing's ready to fall apart soon. Soon. I might solder a new one on there. This is way too short. So you don't feel pain. Put it back in here. This is blue green on plastic. Made in Malaysia. See factory. Code. This is date code. And there's a date code. It's got the date code on the sticker. Yeah, this can't be like 1981. The model number. You only have 6 watt output. I believe the speaker has to be like a 3 watt. It could be a 6 watt because this is actually good. Compared with the Super Radio can put out, this can put more than this one can. Yeah. And that one's only a 3 watt. Which is amazing that only that's only for 3 watt for that being a 3 watt. This can up for this. This can up for that clock radio. This clock radio can be outperformed. So, yeah. This clock radio, I like it. And there's a microphone jack. And then the knob for the AM, FM. And I did test it with distance. I had to put it near the window. My trailer's kind of hard to get single. I think I had test distance with it. I think I have gotten sitting with the Phillips unboxing it, this unboxing it. I think it can pick up Indiana, which is in Dayton. It can also pick up Kentucky, because where I live, in a very small town. I can pick. I'm close to the Kentucky. It's still close. I'm close to Kentucky. I'm on the side of Ohio, much closer to Kentucky. For now, then we'll be moving again. Supposedly getting a house. Yeah, the clock works. And that's a kid's time. I like the air clocks that goes fast by themselves, which I hate that. Or slow down once or time. But this one actually seems to keep time right. And then they're all. I can show it the radio. So, can you show me the current for this vlog radio? This vlog radio came out around around the 80s. I seem to care what's deep inside, frightened of this thing that I've become. Gotta make a lot to take me away from you. This has never been me no more than I do. I get the rain down in Africa. Gotta make for the AM. Oh, we can get it. I usually get. Here's the dial, there you.
All of a sudden, you're going 90 and you have no idea why.
So, this is the song for the Ed Man. When this one comes on.
This is one of them. I hear this song.
That I was playing golf with Donald Trump, and I was standing beside him with a club in my hand. I was, you know, considering my options.
I don't know what that was. I think it's just kind of a weird device. And I did 50 Dirty ESPN. Oh, yeah. And this one. WBJM is the oldie station. So it's 14280. Before I get that to pick up.
Mike Florio of Pro Football Talk. Mike?
As you see, radio.
What about the anthem protest? Reed knelt for the anthem in San Francisco.
See, now I'm,
what about the anthem protest? Are you going to do
there's
that?
ESPN radio, so.
And Reed wouldn't commit to it because he wasn't sure of the answer.
Yeah, I got 1530 years on AM is ESPN radio. But yeah, it works. This clock radio is really good. And I use it, it's just like my bedroom clock radio. This is the one I use in my bedroom a lot because it actually works and it gets good sound. So, yeah. That's it. Please leave a comment and subscribe if you are new to this video. Please thumbs down and please leave a comment too if you have any questions. There you go.